Hi, I'm Dr. Amanda, and I'm an orthodontist. I'm also the CEO of StraightSmile Solutions. We help dentists all over the world understand orthodontics better. We work with all systems, braces, appliances, and brands of aligners, and we support all systems and brands. This video will share content that is the property of Invisalign and Align Technology. We've made this video upon request of 40,000 plus doctors, subscribers, and followers to help them achieve better outcomes with their Invisalign cases. We do not work for Align Technology. All opinions expressed in this video are the opinions of StraightSmile Solutions and not Align Technology. Thank you to Align Technology for continuing to support us educating and helping their doctors and letting us share this video around the world through YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, LinkedIn, and all of our social media platforms. Together, we unite to make more smiles. If you have questions or concerns about this video, please contact us directly at www.straightsmilesolutions.com. Enjoy the video.
Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, StraightSmileSolutions.com, and today we're going to be talking about the newest version of ClinCheck. I believe it's ClinCheck 6.0. Am I getting this right? 8.0? I can't keep track of them. But in any case, it is October 2020, so whatever one just came out. So I wanted to go over a few tips and tricks that I found that are pretty cool on the new ClinCheck. And as always, I have to give this disclaimer. These opinions are the opinions of myself and Straight Smile Solutions. I'm just an orthodontist. I make these videos not for profit, but to help people who ask for help. And I post them because doctors need help. And yes, I do orthodontic consulting, and I do help doctors if they ask for help with their ClinChecks. That's part of what I do. But I also offer these free videos, and doctors from around the world can access them to do better work with Invisalign. So I would really appreciate it if Invisalign would not send me any more nasty emails from their legal teams or letters from their legal teams threatening to sue me when I post these, because really it's meant to benefit Invisalign and patients and doctors. We all win. And if you, Invisalign, cannot explain things well and easily, then other people need to. And doctors are asking for this help. So I'm doing this just to help. Please do not give me a hard time. Thank you so much for the disclaimer. All right, so y'all, I would go into an actual ClinCheck and show you around how this stuff works, but I get nasty letters from Align Technology when I do that. So can't do that. You know, they're a little bit of a bully sometimes. But in any case, we'll see how long this stays up before I get a letter in the mail. And if they're smart, they would realize this is just to help them. And I take a little bit of offense when they send me rude letters in the mail. Anyways, all right. But you know, that's big business. That's big technology. Sometimes they don't think about the why behind, you know, people are just trying to help you. So in any case, let's talk a little bit about the newest, latest, and greatest. And this is all positive. So please do, Align Technology, let me keep this video up. I put a lot of time and effort into creating these. So, and it's just to help people. All right, no more talking about that. I just wanted to get my point across. Couple things that have come up a lot. Yes, you can add more photos and x-rays after a ClinCheck is ready for review, but what you need to do is go into the notes, go into the revision, say, hey, I'm going to add a pano, or I'm going to add some additional photos where I've used articulating paper and I'd like you to take another look and do another setup or something like that. You do that, and then once you do that, you email the records with the patient name and ID number with the attachments to records@aligntech.com. Okay. Personally, I recommend giving them a call on the doctor support line and letting them know too. I think it goes faster and they often review it quicker if you do that. And it kind of connects all the dots. If you don't see any movement on traction on this after a few days, I would repeat. And ultimately it's good. But yes, you should always submit a pano if you have one. Absolutely. Because you're going to get a way better ClinCheck if you submit x-rays, right? Of course. So, okay, so let's talk about the white, yellow, and blue diamonds that are in your ClinCheck treatment plan that's associated with IPR. And I have a lot of videos on how to do IPR. And if you want to access them, feel free to reach out to us at StraightSmileSolutions.com. They are totally free and we'd be glad to show you how to do better and more efficient IPR. But basically, in a nutshell, white diamonds show the total amount of IPR. As always, I believe there shouldn't be any more than 0.5 millimeters historically cumulative per interproximal space, but they will do way more than that if you don't stop them. So you really need to realize that if you're prescribing IPR, this is just a suggestion from a from some software. They don't know if that's okay. So, I mean, there's so many things you need to take into account and before you okay that IPR, right? I mean, first of all, I like to think, is this a filling? Do I want to do IPR on this filling? Certainly, I don't necessarily want to do it on crown. I might be okay on an amalgam. I don't want to do it on a veneer. I do want to do it on natural teeth, but also it depends on how much enamel the patient has. And I think more than ever, a lot of people aren't thinking, a lot of patients are retreatment cases for previous, you know, aligners or even braces, and they may have had IPR before. So you really need to look at the shape of that tooth, and you need to look at the bite wings of the posterior, and you need to look at the PAs in the anterior, and you need to measure that enamel and say, can I do IPR? Because I've seen people get pulpal death from overdoing IPR and, you know, needing a root canal. So think about it before you do it, and don't let too much IPR be done if that's not something you feel comfortable with, okay? So as you drag the orange little slider at the bottom of your ClinCheck, the diamonds will turn yellow, and that shows you when you need to do the IPR by. It's like, I like to give the analogy, it's like a library book. You need to get it done before that date. So you can do the IPR anytime before, you know, it's due, basically. And then once it turns blue, the IPR is completed. All right. And then remember, you can historically, on the revision, it's going to show you, hey, you've already done 0.4 millimeters, plus we're adding 0.2 millimeters. Don't go over that 0.5. You need to be cognizant of what was done. Check your charting. Did I actually do it? You know, and if they're asking for too much perinterproximal space, you can ask them to restage it more posterior or on other teeth, if it's possible. Not always possible, okay? This is a really popular one. How do I share my ClinCheck with a patient? And this is a new feature. I'm having some issues with it, and maybe it's because I have a Mac, but they have two different workflows. One if you have ClinCheck Pro, one if you don't. But the one that you don't still doesn't work for me. So, but this is what I see when I go in on my computer. So when I go to the newest ClinCheck, this is the newest one, and I click on the patient's name, and then it's gonna say what type of treatment it is, and then it's gonna say export, and then it's supposed to say movie screenshots, STL or sample case. Mine only says screenshots and STL. So the screenshot shows me the before and after, just a static image. The STL is the STL. That's nothing you can do with an STL, but this is cool. This is something very, very new that I didn't even know that they had. So I wanna give, I've been asking for this. So I wanna give Align kudos for having this because I can see a big need for this. For example, I want to export my STL to my local lab because perhaps my Invisalign treatment is going to be combined with a combination of veneers afterwards. So I want to see if the final setup, the final stage, you know, let's say this is 20 aligners. If aligner 20, the way the setup is that they've set it up, so I can do a digital treatment planning. So I can do a digital wax up. So I want to send that final STL to my you can either only do initial or final, basically. They're not gonna let you do all the STLs. That would be smart because then you just export it to some third party lab and they'd make white label aligners. Uh-huh. So of course they're not dumb. They're not gonna do that, but you can get the final one and I'm cool with that. That's all I wanted. So that way I can do virtual wax ups and things like that. So I can show the patient what it's gonna look like with the restorative, right? And it's really accurate. So, and we can plan in advance for like, the spatial staging and stuff like that. So it's awesome. However, I'd like to say that I was super excited about this and I went to try it out today. Didn't work. I got an error message. So I don't know if there's a bug in the system or again, if it's just me, but it wasn't working for me. But the fact that it's there is huge. So this is how you do that. Okay. This is how you do it with, oh yeah, and this is what it's supposed to look like, STL export, initial stage or final stage. And then this is their TOS. They say it's there to help you develop more efficient dental treatment plans, which may integrate with Invisalign or other dental procedures. Awesome, fantastic. It is not intended for manufacturing aligners or retainers to straighten or retain teeth. That's fine. So If the ClinCheck plan related to this STL is not accepted or is later canceled, they reserve the right to charge you for the creation of the... Oh, I didn't even get that until I saw that now. So this is really, really, really important and very smart. I support this. So they're saying that if you go, because you know how you can do a workup and you may not proceed with it, okay? So if you go and you do a workup and you export that STL, they might charge you for it if you do not accept to actually pay for the treatment. So they reserve the right to do that. Very, very smart. And I totally support that online technology. That makes sense. So anyways, if you're using ClinCheck Web, if you want to share the treatment plan, this is how you do it with the patient. You're going to click share. Like I said, I already did. And I have ClinCheck Web. And then they're going to tell you what things you want the patients to see. Attachments, bite ramps, power arms. What the heck's a power ridge? Precision cuts, IPR spaces, or pontics. So you can select supposedly and not select different things if you don't want the patient to get like overwhelmed by all the different things that are there. You could just make it just the teeth only, depending on what you're trying to share with them. You're gonna hit share, and then what it's gonna do is the patient gets two emails from Invisalign. And a lot of times this is how doctors communicate with me too. If they don't want to do a Zoom meeting, or if you want to go over a case, sometimes they'll send it to me. Like, I'm a patient and I'll get two different emails. One of them will be the initial email. You'll have to put in a password, which comes in a separate email. So it's not unlike what they do with HIPAA compliant email, where it comes in two different things and you have a password, and then it doesn't say the patient's name on it. So you're just going to get this random setup in the mail. So I mean, obviously my doctors, when they communicate with me like that, they'll send me a message through my secure email, say, hey, I'm going to send you the ClinCheck for Sally B, and it's coming right now. So when I get it, I know, oh, that's Sally B's setup, but it doesn't have our name or any PHI on it at all. So that's how that works, basically. So, all right. So basically, in a nutshell, this first review I did was a little bit more about the newest ClinCheck, IPR staging, IPR quantification, cumulative IPR, and how to share a ClinCheck and how to export an STL from the initial or final stage of your ClinCheck. All right, stay tuned. I have a little bit more coming shortly. Hey, this is Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and we're going to move on to part two of our updates with our new ClinCheck in 2020. Couple more cool things that are happening right now that you can access. First of all, yes, you can view various ClinCheck treatment plans side by side, which I love. A lot of times I'll work up multiple treatment plans. One has IPR, one doesn't have IPR, one we fix the midlines, one we don't fix the midlines. Once we just do anterior movement, one we do full movement with elastics and fix the bite. I might have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 options. And now you can easily toggle. There was a toggle button before, and you may have seen my other videos, but now you can just go to this button right here, which is on the left top side, and you can see the various setups, and you can bring them all up or compare one with another. So that way the patient can see A versus B and they can understand it. So it's really great. So basically, open ClinCheck, click on treatment timeline, select the treatment plans you want to compare, click on tools view and compare plans. You can do up to 4 treatment plans at one time. So really great. Good thing about this new ClinCheck is you can hover your mouse over the different buttons and it tells you what they are. So in time, and you could also reorganize the whole top panel to make it easier to understand. So to configure. So that's pretty cool. All right. Another cool thing you can do now is you can enter private notes in the ClinCheck. By the way, this little thing is a little thing if you have private notes. But you can click on that and you can add notes. Like, I mean, obviously you're probably putting notes in your own practice management system, but this is a great way to make notes about things that you talked about that are related to the Invisalign treatment. Because if you've got a lot of Invisalign cases going on, you're gonna forget. So it just pops up and it's a private note and only you and your team is gonna see them. And if you've created staff accounts, the staff won't be able to necessarily see them, just the doctor. So, and I do recommend that if you are doing Invisalign, one of the best things about, and again, people, Invisalign likes to think that I don't like them, which is so not the truth at all. I madly respect Invisalign and I like the fact that I can give feedback and a lot of times they listen to it and then they create new things because all these ideas were ideas that I already gave them. So these are things that were on my list. When I met with them last year in person, I told them, here's things I want you to work on. Here's things doctors are asking for. And I don't know, maybe they already had them in the pipeline, but pretty much everything I told them I liked and that I wanted them to do, they did. So, you know, that's awesome. But yeah, I mean, it's super important, and it's really important. One of the best parts when I talk to people that are considering Invisalign, I say, look, they have the best possible dashboard. They're constantly updating their dashboard. What you are paying for, yes, they have a high lab fee, but you're paying for convenience. You're paying for an all-in-one solution. You're paying for this dashboard where if you're in a big office, you can have one master account and multiple doctor accounts under one, you know, master account that's run by the owner. You can have sub-staff accounts and consultant accounts that go under as a staff with all with different, you know, permissions. Someone is only dealing with money. Someone's only dealing with, you know, ClinChecks and impressions and whatever. So different people have different permissions and different access. And it's really, really great that you can do that. And if you're not sure how to do it, I mean, it is a little bit complicated, but you can definitely talk to your TM or territory manager. And if you don't know who your TM is, I think now more than ever, we don't necessarily have a lot of direct contact with our TMs like we used to. They'd all come to our office and bring donuts and whatever. And they mine stopped by like every other week. You know, and we were going out to lunch and going over cases and they'd like hands-on help you. Well, they don't have the bandwidth for that anymore. You know, they have way more doctors they work with. And unless you are a super high status doctor, that's probably not happening. So, you know, everybody needs help. So definitely feel free to connect with me. I'm glad to give you some tips and tricks on managing your ClinChecks. But yeah, the notes feature is really awesome. That's great. Lastly, I think we already talked about IPR a lot, but keep an eye on the red flags on the IPR diamonds. That's super important, especially in your revisions, refinements. You need to know how much previous IPR was done. And remember, that's just based on your treatment plan. If the patient has had Invisalign in the past, it's not going to be on there. So as always, you need to take x-rays and you need to think before you prescribe IPR, you know? So, and I like to keep my max like this. 0.5 millimeters. All right. Thanks so much. Hopefully that was helpful.